This is a straightforward and to-the-point tutorial on how to use Toon Boom. It's specifically designed for artists used to animating in Adobe Animator Flash, but you can still use this tutorial without any experience. Launch Toon Boom, browse to the project folder you want to save the animation you're about to start, choose your project's size settings, create scene. Toon Boom creates a folder for the entire scene, so this is very different from Flash. Every scene has its own folder. You need to copy this entire folder to move a scene or back it up. The first thing that will confound you when you start using Toon Boom is everything you draw is pixelated. This is because Toon Boom does not render your drawings in real time. If you want to see what your stage actually looks like, you need to click the blue flower icon above the timeline. This is render view, and you can't live playback or scrub your timeline. You have to click back to the gray flower to do that. Being unable to see real-time results is weird, but you get used to it. Which brings up the next conundrum: the render preview shows the stage as black, and when your outlines are black, you can't see anything. To fix this, click the plus button on the timeline and choose color card. Drag the art layer up so it isn't nested in the color card. By default, the card is white, but you can change it by double-clicking the layer. In preview view, when you click to a different layer, those squares go away. Color cards are opaque layers, so they'll export with your animation unless you hide them by clicking these eyes before exporting. Lock the layer so you don't end up selecting it on accident all the time. Moving on to drawing tools. The keyboard shortcuts for drawing tools in Toon Boom are different from Adobe, so you're going to have to relearn them. If you absolutely need to, you can change shortcuts under Edit, Preferences, in the Drawing Mode category. Click and hold on any tool with a little arrow on it to access tools nested beneath it. While you're drawing, the abilities of whatever tool you're using show up in the Tool Properties window. The pencil shows the style types. You can create a new style by clicking this arrow, and then one of these tiny little buttons at the top of the window to add new or overwrite old. Below style choices are options such as paint behind, autofill, end trimming, and other options Flash doesn't have that you can play with. There are lots of options you won't be familiar with, so experiment. Tools you won't recognize at all include cutter, which you can slash over a hanging line to auto-delete. Often it only selects the segment and you have to press the delete key. Stroke and close gap tools work on invisible lines, which I'll talk about later. Drawing pivot sets the transformation point, which you'll need because in Toon Boom, the default pivot point for everything is the center of the stage. Morphing tool, think of this as advanced shape tweens. You'll have to watch tutorials on how to use the morphing tool if you want to do shape tweens in Toon Boom. Animate button, which is for tweening. And below that, Toon Boom's free transform tool, which affects the layer properties, not the art itself. What that means is you should use the Select tool to scale, rotate, and skew art. The Transform tool is for tweens and impermanent layer adjustments you can undo by resetting the layer properties. You can see a layer's properties by clicking the plus button on that layer, minus to collapse it. Under Transform is a tool you already know, Onion Skin, but with easy adjustment buttons above the drawing area plus the handles on the timeline that you're used to. To change drawing color, you need to pick a swatch from a palette. Make a new swatch with plus, double-click to edit. All Toon Boom colors work as if they were linked swatches in Flash. Draw anywhere in the entire scene with one swatch, and if you change that swatch, it changes all of the places you used it. Every color you draw with must have a swatch. You can't just grab whatever random colors you want, like in Flash. Because you might have a lot of colors, you can keep things organized with multiple palettes. Something very different about Toon Boom is every layer in the timeline has a layer for line art and a layer for color art within it. Higher tier versions of Toon Boom give you an overlay and an underlay layer in addition to that, which you can turn on under Edit, Preferences, Advanced, Support Overlay and Underlay Arts. To change which layer you're drawing on, click on this bar. If you can't see the bar, right-click in this area, Art Layer. One of the best ways to use these is to draw the line art on the line layer. Select the art, then click Create Color Art from Line Art button in Tool Properties. Now go to the color layer. Invisible outlines appear. Use your paint bucket to fill in the outlines. If there are gaps indicated by these yellow nodes, you can close them with the Close Gap tool or the Stroke tool for drawing shapes with invisible outlines. Toon Boom gets even weirder because right now we are in camera view. Click this tab to go to Drawing View. suddenly all we see is the color art, because drawing view only shows us the layer we are working on, and it hides any transformations you might have made with the camera or the layer itself. So, say in camera view you grab the transform tool and rotate your layer. Go to drawing view. Those transformations are hidden. Maybe you can tell already, but this is really useful. If you're in drawing view and you do want to see all of the layers at once, click the eye at the top of the column. To display all of the layers in the timeline, click the light above the drawing area. Unlike Flash, drawing tools only work on the part of the layer you're working on, and all strokes are independent entities, so you'll never worry about lining over your colors or coloring over lines or erasing a hole through all of your unlocked layers. However, in Toon Boom, you will accidentally forget to switch back to the line art layer and end up drawing on the color layer, which means you have to cut all the stuff you made in the wrong place and paste it to the right place. Sometimes you want to edit the line art and the color art at the same time, and you can do that by picking a tool like the eraser and turning on this option. Once you're used to the tools, you can do things that would be unimaginable in Flash, like turn an entire layer into color art, then color every single frame with one click. This trick only works with small spacing, i.e. the art can't move too far from its start point. Now let's talk about differences in frame-by-frame animation. For the most part, it's what you would expect. Draw a picture, click the next frame, draw the next picture. Click once, click again, hold, and drag a frame to change timing. Use the plus and minus keys to lengthen or shorten a frame's duration. Click and drag over blank frames, and then hit this button to fill in gaps. The weird thing about Toon Boom is that drawings are linked. So if you copy one drawing and paste it over here, then draw something new, it affects your original drawing too. The way to stop this from happening is to copy your drawing, paste it, and then click this duplicate drawing button to create a new drawing. You'll notice the name of the drawing changes too. And now when you draw, the first picture stays the same. Do not expect to be able to copy drawings from one layer and paste them into another. You can do this in Flash, but you cannot do this in Toon Boom. You'll have to use the Select tool to copy the art, and then go to the new layer and paste the art. Don't try to paste frames to and from different layers, it'll mess things up. To make an animation loop, you copy and paste drawings. It's not the greatest, but it works. For tweening animations, there are no symbols. Toon Boom has symbols, but forget about them, you don't need them. Click on the layer you want to tween. Then click this orange curve button in the timeline. This makes a peg. In Toon Boom, you animate pegs, not the art itself. Once you have a peg, make sure the animate button is turned on, then select the free transform tool. Click the peg layer. Drag your art where you want it to go. The tween appears on the peg layer, and there are tools in the timeline that let you add or remove keyframes and set easing type for selected keyframes. These two buttons switch keyframes between tweens and stop motion. Stop motion keyframes let the art jump from one position to the next without sliding around in between. The transform tool isn't the only one you can use for making tweens. Any of the blue advanced animation tools up here are for tweening as well. You can nest layers within layers, pegs within pegs, and do all of the layer building to make a puppet directly in the timeline without ever touching a symbol. To add and animate a camera, plus button, camera. Add a peg to the camera and animate the peg like you would anything else. If your camera is being stupid, click the peg, right-click the drawing area, show path and control parameters. Get your transform tool, click a node, in the menu, animation, linear motion. Click the next node. Keep doing this. It's annoying and tedious, but I haven't found a more efficient way to fix it. When you're finished, click the peg layer, right-click the drawing area, and pick the option to hide the curve. Masks in Toon Boom are called a cutter effect. To apply an effect to a layer, click it, then plus button, effects, cutter. Uncollapse cutter. You need a matte layer. Duplicate the layer you want to use as a mask, click and drag that layer to the matte box. Finally, double-click on cutter and check inverted. There's your mask. Effects only work on individual layers. If you need to put a single effect on a set of multiple layers, you'll have to select all of the layers, right-click, group selection. Click on the group, not the layers, plus button, effect, and pick your effect. Most effects won't show up unless you are in render view, so you'll need to click the blue flower to see if it looks right. On to the library. Works like Flash, but not really. First, start a new library by right-clicking Open Library. Choose a place to create a library where you're going to save puppets and art for use in other Toon Boom animations. Select Folder. Right-click on the library, right to modify. Highlight, drag, and drop animations you want to reuse into the library. If you want to edit something in the library, you must make sure you have Right to Modify checked for the library, then right-click the item, Edit Template. Save it when you're done. Open any Toon Boom scene and drag things from the library into the scene to use them. To preview your animation, click the Play button. Turn sound playback on or off with the audio buttons. Loop the preview with the Loop button. Change which section is looping by adjusting the black stop and start arrows. The starred play button creates a render preview. This exports every frame in your selection to the frames folder in your scene, and then loads those frames into a player and previews them for you. Remember to delete these images at some point to free up file space, so I usually clean out all of the frames folders in my scenes when an animation is finished and online. Finally, exporting. File, export, movie. You don't get many options. To preserve the integrity of anything you imported to Toon Boom, say painted backgrounds, you need to export every keyframe at the highest quality. For After Effects, or any other type of compositing you plan to do outside Toon Boom that involves putting things with transparent backgrounds on top of other things, everybody recommends exporting a PNG sequence instead of a movie file with an alpha channel. Use PNG sequences, it takes up a lot less file space. You can export SWIFTs out of Toon Boom, but they only work for very specific things, the most basic lines and colors without any effects or textured lines. That is a really solid, condensed tutorial on getting started with Toon Boom. This doesn't cover any of the Toon Boom premium features, that tier is too expensive for my budget, but it is everything you'll need to know to get started without all of that awkward flailing because it's so different from Flash. Make some great animations, and if you're looking for more straight-to-the-point tutorials I've made, see the description below.